In this video, we are going to solve problems on Pilterwheel turbine, where we will calculate number of jets, diameter of runner, and number of buckets on runner. Here statement is, a Pilton turbine is required to work under a head of 40 meter to develop 150 kW at 250 rpm, assuming coefficient of velocity for nozzle equal to 0.98, speed ratio equal to 0.46. Mechanical efficiency equal to 96%. Clearance angle of bucket equal to 15 degree. Bucket friction factor equal to 0.85. Find diameter of runner, jet diameter, number of jet required, number of buckets. So here in this problem, to calculate all these values, first I will write down given data which has been provided in problem. Here available head, capital H, is 40 meter. Power developed is 150 kW at speed 250 rpm. The velocity coefficient for nozzle, that is Cv equal to 0.98. Speed ratio equal to 0.46, which is the ratio of bucket speed small u divided by velocity of jet V1. Here mechanical efficiency is 96%, that is equal to 0.96. And plate angle phi is 15 degree. Bucket friction factor equal to 0.85. First of all, we want to calculate diameter of runner, that is capital D. So to calculate this value, we use the formula of bucket speed small u, which is equal to pi d n by 60. And to calculate small u, we have speed ratio 0.46. And for velocity of jet V1 is given by formula Cv into under root 2gh, where h is 40 meter and velocity coefficient for nozzle is 0.98. A small g is acceleration of gravity, which is 9.81. By calculating, this will give me the value of velocity of jet V1 as 27.45 meter per second. And I'll substitute bucket speed small u and speed n equal to 250 rpm. So this will give me the value of diameter of runner capital D as 0.965 meter. Next, we want to determine diameter of jets. So to get this value, I will use discharge formula, that is area of jet small a, multiply with velocity of jet V1, where area of jet is nothing but pi by 4 d square, and here d is the diameter of jet. Here we need to calculate discharge rate. So in problem, they have mentioned that the mechanical efficiency is 96%, that is equal to 0.96, and it is given by this formula, where output power of wheel is provided in given data divided by hydraulic power produced, which is rho g qh. So from here, I will calculate discharge rate, capital Q, as 0.3982 meter cube per second. So with discharge and velocity of jet V1, we will get small d as 0.136 meter. And with the help of small d and capital D, which we have calculated earlier, I will get value of jet ratio small m as 7.1. But in problem, they have mentioned that jet ratio is not to be less than 10. Therefore, here one jet ratio is not sufficient. Therefore, I will take small m jet ratio equal to 10. And I'll replace small d with small d1, which is actual diameter of jet. So from here, the actual diameter of jet we got as 0.0965 meter. Next, we want to calculate number of jet required, that is small n, which is the ratio of discharge rate capital Q and discharge per jet small q, which is given by formula, that is area multiply with velocity of jet V1, and area is pi by 4 d1 square. And we had calculated actual diameter of jet D1 as 0.0965 meter. Therefore, we will get number of jets required is 2. That means 2 jets of diameter 0.0965 meter are required. At the last, we want to calculate number of buckets, capital Z, and it is given by formula 15 plus 0.5 into Z ratio small m, where small m is 10. So this will give me the number of buckets, capital Z, equal to 20 buckets.